Northwest Incident Management Team 7's Public Information Officer Al DeVos brings some insight about the Oregon National Guard helicopters assigned to the Lionshead and P-515 fires on the Warm Springs Reservation.
My name is Second Lieutenant Nolan Radar. So I'm a second lieutenant. I am currently here with Golf 1189 Aviation Regiment, providing support for the P-515 and Lionshead fire.
So what sort of aviation resources do you guys bring into town today?
So we brought in four Blackhawks. Three of them are set up to fight fires.
Yep.
And we have one bird that is set up to provide medevac support for the surrounding areas.
Okay. Now, are these Blackhawks specifically made for fighting fires, or do you have to do any special adjustments to get them ready to get out there and fight?
So these Blackhawks are all set up for medevac support. The only real setup we need to do for getting them ready for fires is basically just attaching a firefighting bucket on a sling load.
Okay. So, hey, Nolan, tell us, once they're going out there on the missions, what's a typical mission going to be like based on the briefing that you got this morning?
So traditionally, what the helicopters are going to do is they're going to get tasked out to certain fire locations. They're going to spin up, fly out, start grabbing buckets of water and dumping them on the actual fire.
Well, I know the team is really happy to have you here because we're working in steep and rough terrain, and that's been one of our concerns, is being able to evacuate a firefighter if they're injured at night with no vehicle access if they needed rapid extraction. So we're really happy about the capability you're bringing, but can you tell us a little bit about the crew that flies in these helicopters?
Absolutely, and we're happy to be here to help. So a typical crew will consist of a pilot in command whose primary job is to basically dictate and direct the goings on in the aircraft. A pilot who is there to assist when flying and help the pilot in command do whatever he needs to do, whether it be radio calls or actually just flying the aircraft. And then for the fire capable helicopters, they are typically going to have just a crew chief in the back who is helping direct the pilot and pilot in command maneuver the aircraft over the actual fire spot so they can drop the buckets. And the medical aircraft will have a medic and a hoist operator in the back seat as well. So 3 to 4 people in the aircraft.
Of the Blackhawks you bought for medical support, are they equipped to, or how are they equipped in terms of operational periods? Is it day only, day and night, or can you tell us about any special capabilities they have?
Yeah, so our Blackhawks are, especially the medevac ones, are currently here capable to do day and night medevac missions. They have an external hoist where if they need to do a rough terrain rescue or pickup, they can hoist a medic down, secure the patient, and then load them back into the aircraft. And then at that point, they will take them to whatever level of field care that they need, whether it be a hospital or not.
A big thank you to all the firefighters. Stay safe out there.